So good morning to all. My name is Keith Cornell, and I have the pleasure of serving as president at Heartland Community College. And we want to welcome all of you here to our newest facility, our Heartland Community College electric vehicle training facility in Bloomington. It's great to see all of you here today and to have you joining us. We are very pleased to be joined by Governor Pritzker and Director Garcia, as well as our friends from Rivian. Thanks also to the other guests, including the members of the Heartland Board of Trustees. They're a group of individuals that have nurtured this college and developed into what it has become and are leading us on our quest to become the premier community college in the state of Illinois and in the Midwest. We also want to thank and welcome all of the elected officials who have played such an important part of our region and our state's economic growth and development and have been instrumental in helping us to get this program started here, this unique program that we have in the state. As a former mechanic myself earlier in my adult life, I'm always excited to get back into the garage, and it brings back many fond memories of the lessons and the skills that I learned as a young mechanic, lessons that I use today, even in the current job as president of the college. Though we stand here in what seems to be a garage, it's much more than that. It is a classroom, and it's a workshop, and it's a lab energy storage technology program. It's an exciting new development for us here at Heartland, and we're glad to show off to all of you the beginnings of this program. This is my favorite type of an event that I have the privilege of attending, and the reason for that is because we have our students actively involved with us today, and you'll meet some of them in just a while. And it's going to be wonderful for all of you to see what Heartland Community College is all about. We are about helping people to gain the educations and skills that they need to get a job, get a better job, or to open the doors to a new career. Community college have long been essential to the economic vitality of our nation, our state, and right here in our local communities. It's our mission to provide an affordable and equitable pathway for those seeking to further their education and prepare for a career. Heartland's work-ready vocational programs and certificates provide an opportunity to upskill and advance in the workforce, exactly what community colleges are all about. Our short-term programs and certifications provide a fast track towards a job that employers tell us are needed today and into the future. Thanks to our collaboration with industry partners like Rivian, and with the significant impact of the manufacturing training grant that we announced just last April, we are underway with our electric vehicles and energy storage program. We affectionately call it the EVES program. We, in the next 5 years, will train more than 360 individuals who will complete actually their training and be able to step into the workforce. This first-of-a-kind program provides cutting-edge training to develop new talent for the higher-paying jobs of the future and to enhance retention of manufacturers in central part of the state as well as our downstate communities. In a few moments, you will get to meet some of the first students that are receiving the instruction that we are providing here and see some examples of the kind of hands-on learning that happens in our EVES program. Where we stand today is a glimpse of what EVES facility with laboratory training and storage space constructed on our main campus just a few miles from where we stand right now. This manufacturing training academy, one of only two in the entire state of Illinois, is part of the economic vision for growth and equity put forward by the governor's five-year economic plan. plan, which offers a blueprint for growth among the state's strongest and highest growth potential sectors, including advanced manufacturing. I'm sure that Governor Pritzker has much more to share and say about all of that. So without any further hesitation, it is my privilege to introduce the governor of the state of Illinois, Governor Pritzker.
Well, thank you very much, Mr. President. It's so great to be back here at Heartland and to be with all of you. I really am pleased to see all the growth that's taking place in this region, and it's in part because of the great work being done here. I want to thank all of the folks who are involved in helping to lift up this program that we're highlighting today. People have been very focused, nose to the grindstone on getting this up and running, and it really is just spectacular. I want to also thank today and recognize the leaders at Rivian who are here with us, Zach Dietmeyer, who you'll hear from a little later, and Ted Foos. And I want to thank them not only for their presence here, but also for the impact that Rivian has already made here in Bloomington Normal, in the community, with 1,000 hires in just the last 3 months alone. That is worth applause, everybody. I speak for myself as well as my partners in state government, including the terrific Speaker of the House, Chris Welch, who's here with us today, Leader Dave Kaler, Senators Sally Turner and Jason Barrickman, Leader Dan Brady, Representatives Mike Zaleski and Dave Vella, as well as our Department of Commerce and Economic Opportunity Director, Sylvia Garcia, and of course, Mayor Chris Coos. We have a Foos and a Coos with us today. So, I really do want to emphasize my gratitude for their partnership in putting Illinois on the electric vehicle map. And of course, the most important reason that we're all here, which is to recognize the first class of students of this. We're all very proud of the path that they're on to a terrific future in this new industry, a path that they're paving that will open up hundreds of opportunities for their future peers in the next years to come. You are Illinois' really single most important resource, the talented people embracing the next steps in your careers in a new industry that's growing right here in this community. It's one of the reasons that in 2021 alone, dozens of manufacturers like Rivian have either relocated to Illinois or have expanded here. Just last week, Ferrero broke ground at its first ever chocolate processing plant outside of Europe, just a few miles from where we stand today. It's a $75 million facility and will add at least 50 more jobs and many more to come. I've spoken with the leadership at Ferrero, and they're really excited about their opportunity here in the state of Illinois. So I'm looking forward to their growth as well. Illinois is at the center of the action for investment and growth during this economic recovery. And nowhere is that more true than when it comes to electric vehicle manufacturing. Already, we're well on our way to becoming the best state in the nation to manufacture and drive an electric vehicle. Our nation-leading climate action plan will put 1 million electric vehicles on the roads by 2030. We'll provide $4,000 of an electric vehicle rebate for car buyers all across the state of Illinois. And the plan also offers companies up to an 80% rebate for the build-out of charging stations so that we'll have the broadest network of charging stations in the nation. We're not stopping there. Alongside the leaders that are with me here today, our partners in the General Assembly, we're working to double down on our investments in electric vehicle manufacturing and suppliers. With the legislative package that we're putting forward, Illinois will stake out our ground, and Illinois will find our exceptionally talented workforce ready to fill the jobs that they're bringing. Thanks in large part to community colleges like Heartland that educate our next generation of leaders and serve as economic engines for our state. I love that the president was highlighting the importance of community colleges to our state. I couldn't agree more. We need more emphasis on it. We need more investment in it. And we want people to come and learn and take a new job, a better job, after they are able to graduate from great institutions like this one. In fiscal year 2020 alone, our community colleges generated over $3.5 billion in economic output and over 43,000 jobs. This administration recognizes that impact and is committed to investing in it. The $15 million that we've dedicated for the manufacturing training academies here at Heartland and at Metro East's Southwestern Illinois College, SWIC, expands on the funding the Rebuild Illinois bipartisan infrastructure program already devotes to upgrading and expanding facilities at community colleges all across Illinois. As governor, I'm committed to building on Illinois' long history of producing a high-quality skilled workforce so that we can maintain our manufacturing prowess for generations to come, and so our residents can earn a good living, ready for the millions of new manufacturing jobs available over the next decade. I want you all to know that when I reach out to companies all across the United States and frankly the world to tell them why they should come to Illinois, one of the very first things I point out to them is the quality of our workforce. And I'm very proud to be able to brag about that for the state of Illinois. Today, thanks to everyone who's here and so many others across the state, we take another step forward in creating economic growth and jobs for the people of Illinois. So thank you. And with that, I'm very pleased to introduce Rivian's senior manager for plant communications and public policy and a longtime champion for the Bloomington Normal region, Zach Dietmeyer.
Well, thank you, Governor. And thank you for coming back to see some of the progress so far on this EV Academy here in Bloomington Normal since our announcements in the spring. I want to keep it short and sweet from the Rivian perspective today and really keep the focus on everything going on here at the Eves Academy and Heartland Community College. This first batch of students and our co-instructors for the program, a lot of excitement. And as you heard mentioned, Rivian has hired the better part of 2,700 new employees in town since the beginning of 2021. We're likely to add about another 500 this year. So there's plenty of more room on all scapes of electric vehicle industry topics here in the next several months as well. So as we focus in, I also want to thank all of our local representatives and legislators here for the support that they have provided in Springfield as well. Rivian is really honored to be part of this continued support in the establishment of the electric vehicle training facility here in Normal. The project is preparing local workers for the technical skills and knowledge that will be needed with this massive transition across the globe in this sector. What we're seeing is a continued growth in clean energy, and the students here are working hard to increase their competencies in electric vehicle industry technology, as well as their experience for Rivian operations firsthand. We had them out a couple of weeks ago, and it was they were running circles around me with the questions. The knowledge that they're building in this sector is very impressive and will lead to increased opportunities for years to come. The project also highlights many of our core values at Rivian's focus of keeping the world adventurous forever. It's community empowerment. It's opportunities and innovation. It's strong foundations for growth and success in the electric mobility surrounding our company and the industry at large. We're currently training and integrating these new employees into our operations as things get off the ground. We're also in the training and electric vehicle ecosystem, and it's really designed to be highly scalable, flexible, integrated, and also interconnected. And we are seeing the beginnings of how this program is really building future experts for just such an environment as is being created here through programs like Heartland. We thank Governor Pritzker, as well as the Illinois DCO, for this opportunity to really push this forward. And as we see new opportunities with suppliers in the area and with other technologies coming on board, we're wholeheartedly supportive of Illinois' continued emphasis on electric vehicle technology. So thank you. And with that, I would like to welcome the...
Well, good morning, everyone. It is truly an honor and a privilege to be here in the heartland of Illinois. Colleagues on each side of the aisle, colleagues in the House, Representative Zaleski and Vella, and my good friend Dan Brady. My first position in leadership was chair of higher education, and Leader Brady and I did some good work together when I served on that committee. So it's good to be in the area with Leader Brady and the good senators in the other chamber. Mayor Coos, good to see you again. I was here a couple of weeks ago speaking to the American Planners Association. Nothing wrong with stopping in the heartland every now and then, especially with great announcements like this going on. I'm really excited to be getting a first look at this lab space for the Electric Vehicle Energy Storage Training Program here at Heartland Community College. I would also be remiss if I didn't thank Rivian and Zach for their partnership with Heartland to create such a wonderful program. I'm impressed with what I see already, and this is just the beginning. We're just getting started. I'm eager to see the finished on-campus facility that was made possible by the Rebuild Illinois Capital Grant. As we try to capitalize on our state's position to lead new industries, I'm pleased to see the real-life implications of this first-of-its-kind program to spur innovation and research and development right here in Illinois. We know that green energy sector is an important part of our future. What we did last month with the Climate and Equitable Jobs Act was so important. And what's going on here today is just one example of our great educational opportunities here in Illinois to meet the demand for that upcoming workforce. This program will offer cutting-edge training programs and will help develop new talent for good-paying union jobs to help uplift and strengthen our working families all across this state. This is how we're going to rebuild Illinois and rebuild our economy. Right here, through the heartland, through community colleges and universities, and in good-paying manufacturing jobs. But it also provides a unique opportunity to our students and workforce downstate, focusing on developing new talent and boosting retention for manufacturers in these downstate communities. It's also really exciting to hear how this program will expand and the coursework will be available online with the hands-on training offered at participating locations throughout the state. We want to ensure that Illinois continues to be a leader in the nation when it comes to green energy. We fought hard, and we're going to continue to fight hard to continue to put Illinois at the forefront. October is National Manufacturing Month, and I'm proud to stand here today to celebrate these continued efforts to ensure Illinois is a leader in the next generation of manufacturing. As the fourth largest manufacturing state in the nation, with over 18,000 companies employing hundreds, Illinois maintains its status as a leader and a model for the rest of the country. Forget what you hear out there. Forget the rhetoric in the partisan space sometimes. Illinois is truly a leader when it comes to green jobs, a green economy, and manufacturing. Thanks to partnerships like this, we will continue to educate and inspire future generations. We see it right here today. And again, I want to thank you all for inviting me. Dr. Cornell, this is such a fabulous place to be here today. I'm really excited about what you have going on here at Heartland Community College. I'm excited to see the success of the students, but also how to build a healthier tomorrow for all of us, our children and our children's children. What a great day to be in the heartland of Illinois. I want to bring up our great director of DCEO, friend of mine, helping us rebuild Illinois one city at a time. Please welcome Director Sylvia Garcia.
Thank you, Speaker Welch. Good morning, everyone. As was mentioned, my name is Sylvia Garcia, and I'm the Acting Director of the Illinois Department of Commerce and Economic Opportunity. I'm very excited to be back here in the Bloomington Normal area. Just last week, I was here for the groundbreaking of the Ferraro Chocolate Manufacturing Center, and today we are here to celebrate Heartland Community College's progress on their new electric vehicle energy storage, or EVES, Manufacturing Training Academy. We are here today thanks to education, industry, and government partners coming together to collaborate and prepare Illinoisans with 21st century manufacturing skills that will help Illinois continue to grow our manufacturing industry for many, many years to come. It's fitting that we're celebrating the first milestone of Heartland's new EVES program during October. As has been mentioned, that's officially Manufacturing Month, and manufacturing has a long history in Illinois, and we take great pride in our manufacturing roots, which is why we enjoy taking an entire month to celebrate that important role that manufacturing has in our diverse economy. Illinois has always been on the leading edge of technological and manufacturing innovation. From the first cell phone and TV remote control to the first all-electric pickup truck made by over 3,000 proud Illinoisans right here in McLean County. This tradition of innovation and ingenuity continues with more and more companies announcing their plans to grow and expand here in Illinois. This is happening for a few core reasons: our infrastructure and access to all modes of transportation, the strength and vibrancy of our communities, and most notably, our people. From day one, the governor has recognized the importance of investing in our people with workforce training support for the future of growth in key industries. We're developing a pipeline of talent to meet current and forecasted workforce trends. The Manufacturing Training Academies program, which includes the EVE Training Center here at Heartland, as well as another state-of-the-art facility at Southwestern Illinois College, are rooted in the governor's five-year economic plan, a blueprint for generating investments and jobs for communities across Illinois. The EVE program here at Heartland will help prepare Illinoisans throughout the region with extensive growth in electric for the extensive growth in the electric vehicle sector and to seize on the highly specialized, well-paid jobs created by companies like Rivian. As states across the country race to meet mandates for clean energy, and as Illinois implements our own bold agenda to address climate change, electric vehicle jobs just in Illinois are expected to double in the next 4 years alone. In closing, I just want to encourage any Illinoisan who's out there who's considering a career in manufacturing to connect with their local community college today. Whether it's electric vehicles or agribusiness, a career in manufacturing is a career for the future. And through our statewide network of community college training partners, we can help you identify training and apprenticeship opportunities near you. Thank you, and congratulations to Heartland. It's now my pleasure to ask Governor Pritzker back up to the stand. Thank you.
I want to, before we take questions, and then we'll do a demo, a training demo, just after we do questions. But before we do that, I want to invite Sylvia Garcia back up here because we want to make a presentation to Heartland. It is Manufacturing Month, and Heartland is playing an important role in helping us to grow our manufacturing economy. So we have a special presentation, a proclamation recognizing Heartland and its great work in the manufacturing economy of the state of Illinois. Why don't you hold on to that, and we'll take a picture together. And again, congratulations on the amazing work that you do here, and you're preparing students for great jobs of the future.
Well, thank you very much.
Appreciate you. Very good, and happy to take questions from members of the media. I see Mike here.
Governor, make your call a million major investments here, planning on training for the future. Will there be enough people willing to train to move towards electric vehicles instead of their gas vehicles right now?
Well, I certainly hope so. We want to attract people to some of the best paying jobs in our economy. These are among them. Good, you know, manufacturing jobs, those are ones that I think many people ought to be aiming at. It's one of the reasons why we're beefing up programs like this here at Heartland. So I believe that we will have the workforce. And, you know, very importantly, the level of education and capability and experience in a program like this is precisely what electric vehicle manufacturers, as well as the suppliers, are looking for. They want to know that, you know, when they come to a state or to a region, that there are enough people who are trained properly. We have terrific people right here in the Bloomington Normal area and others who will move here because in preparing for those kinds of jobs, as we bring new companies to Illinois, what a great combination and a great opportunity for people to, you know, raise their Yeah, that's something we're looking at. There's no intentionality exactly to exclude, but that's something that's going through the legislature right now. So, you know, I'll take a good hard look at it. And I don't know whether it will come up next week in session. I know there are others here who may have more to say about that, but I you know, look forward to reviewing it. Well, my sense is that the map that was put forward was not intended to be a final product. It was intended to be for discussion. Lots of people have discussed, as we've seen. They've seen the maps and wanted to make changes, both the current members of Congress from both parties, as well as members of the legislature who are going to be voting on it. So I have not seen, you know, what changes might be made, but I have no doubt at all that you know, these things in the legislature, this is how the legislature works. You know, you put a proposal out there, you have hearings about it, you listen to the public, you debate amongst each other within committee and outside, and then ultimately try to put together a compromise, something that will meet, you know, as many of the, you know, requirements that each member has, and all the input that they've received, and then, you know, we'll see what the product is, and I'll get to review it, I'm sure, I assume before the end of the legislative session or the veto session next week.
What are the negotiations with Samsung?
Well, we're talking to a lot of companies, I want to be clear, and so, you know, there are battery companies all over the world, as you know, and different kinds of battery technology. It is important for companies like Rivian, as well as other electric vehicle manufacturers, to have a partnership with an existing battery manufacturer and to try to, you know, locate themselves nearby corridor that we're creating for electric vehicle manufacturing. So I'll continue to work with those companies. You know, Samsung is certainly among them. In order to help bring them to Bloomington Normal and throughout this corridor.
Is that my question specifically about Samsung and where it stands now?
You know, that's really not something that I can talk about. I think, you know, as you talk to each company, they've got different requirements. They put forward, you know, their concerns or their suggestions about what would work best for them. But I do want to point out that what we're reviewing now, when we talk about the electric vehicle edge tax credits program that's being discussed in the legislature, that's very important, not just for battery manufacturers and for electric vehicle manufacturers, but for everybody that's in this industry. So those who are manufacturing the tier two and tier three parts for the industry. So I encourage everybody to pay attention and encourage their legislators to help us pass the new, you know, changes to the EDGE tax credit program so that we will be even more attractive for companies like
about is assault against your mandate.
Well, you know, he's a grifter who is taking money from parents who are, you know, being taken advantage of. We are trying to keep kids and parents and grandparents and teachers and everybody that's in the community where of the school safe. That's my job as governor. That's our job as elected officials. And I have to say that, you know, that going around and suing school districts and the governor and the attorney general and everybody else in order to keep people less safe, that makes zero sense to me. So we're going to push back as hard as we can. Certainly we'll, you know, be in court. The attorney general, I just want to praise him and his staff, has done an amazing job. You don't want to spend all of your time doing this. There are an awful lot of things that the attorney general's office does to protect consumers out there. But the more you have to send lawyers out to fight these ridiculous lawsuits that are frankly making people less safe, that are harming our children, then, you know, the less you can do to really lift up the entire state. So I hope that the, you know, reign of grifting and terror that he is trying to bring about in these school districts will come to an end.
Thank you, everyone. Demonstration is going to be over here.
Thank you, Governor.
Thank you.
You guys would like to...